Good afternoon, sir. We are from Group 7, which consists of 10 members.
I'm the group leader, Emily. One of our members, Karen, didn't come for the discussions because she is going to attend for a club meeting.
So as a group of 9 members, we decided to divide the group into two. The first one will be completing the first question and the second one will be completing the second question. So we'll be getting started with the first question. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Tan Jun Han.
Hi, I'm Tang Jemin.
Hi, I'm Tan Jin.
Hi, I'm Vivian Ong Lee Min.
Hi, I'm Lam Jia Min. We are doing the first question, which is, what do you think are the causes of this emergency? And do you think British could have prevented it?
I'm the group leader, Emily Wong Tsu Ching.
Hi, I'm Lin Xixi.
Hi, I'm Hong Yiwen.
Hi, I'm Sarah Patricks. And today we'll be discussing about question 2, which is British took some course of action to control Malayan Communist Party. And we are supposed to discuss how effective these measurements to prevent the communist attacks.
Causes of the emergency. But what is emergency?
Wait for a while, let me serve first.
Alright. Oh, I found it. The Malayan emergency in Malay called Darurat was the Malayan guerrilla war fought between Commonwealth Armed Forces and the Malayan National Liberation Army, MNLA, the military arm of the Malayan Communist Party, MCP, from 1948 until 1960. Malayan emergency was the colonial government's term for the conflict. The MNLA termed it the anti-British National Liberation War. The rubber plantation and tin mining industry had pushed for the use of the term emergency since their losses would not have been covered by Royal Insurance if it had been termed a war.
Aww.
The answer of question when Japan surrendered, the business took 14 days to return to the Malay Peninsula. During the period, the Malay Communist Party, Bintang Tiga, tried to take control of the Malay Peninsula.
Most of the Communist Party members were Chinese who had ideologies discussed. Incident of racial strength, whereby the Chinese who were oppressed by the Japanese soft range on the Malay who were treated well during the Japanese occupation.
We still have the second part of the question.
Do you think the British could have prevented it?
Oh, I don't think British could prevent it. British had found Sultan to cooperate for rooting up Malaysian Communist Party. British found Sultan to cooperate because they want to build a stronger and larger military soldiers.
And there was a Malayan guerrilla war fought between Commonwealth and the Malayan Communist Party, as
she had said just now, but at last British had failed to root up the Malayan Communist Party because the party is too much stronger than Commonwealth, and that's why British have failed. So I don't think that they can prevent it in the city. As British didn't use harsh way like the Malayan Communist did. How about you, Vivian? What do you think?
I think that you mentioned to stop. For example, they have enough food and drinks in their dining bag. Therefore, our country politics becomes stable.
Malayan Communist Party invaded our country, our currency rate dropped drastically.
That seems like a good point. So, finally, the last point is that the rebellion decreased during this era. This is because British actually formed a secret police force to gain control back of our land. This actually resulted in British regaining their control in Malaysia, and also it prevented the Malaya Communist Party from gaining control in our area. So obviously this fact actually affected Malaysia in a positive manner, in a political and economical way, and it has increased our currency drastically. So, based on all these points that we have given, we can conclude that the effectiveness of British has allowed Malaysia to become a country that it is today.
Thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.